and thanks for the invitation. The presenting me, I've been called worse. So basically, what I was planning to do now is to speak a little bit about the procurement regulations in Estonia. Well, basically, they are quite similar to the ones that are in place in Latvia and Lithuania. And the principles of it all are also similar to what Kaspar's just told to all of us, but there are still some nuances. I will give you a short overview of the legislation, about the changes that are going to happen because of the new law going to be in place in the second half of 2017, and a little bit about how the changes will look like and what they will bring with it. I will give you some statistics. This is really exciting, of course. And and I will show you also how the public procurement register in Estonia looks like right now and how it will be in the nearest future. So anyhow, to get onto the train in the year 2026 and go from Tallinn to Trakiski, for example, certainly the track has to be built, and before that it has to be designed. During the same phase and before that, even more, everything has to be studied. And to do that, and as we are using public funds from the Baltic taxpayers and the European taxpayers, or even more, we need to perform public procurements. Basically, a public procurement, you know, it's difficult to talk about it because, you know, it depends on how the people actually perceive it. If you are more in the business with private sector, the system is a little bit different, no? In the public procurements, they're basically set up in a similar way, but due to the usage of public funds, it's more complicated, I would say. So basically, what the public procurement means, it is purchasing of supplies, goods, services, or public works, awarding service concessions, or organizing design contests by contracting authorities and using public money for that. And in Estonia, the system is set up in that way that all of the procedures, the rights and obligations of the subjects involved in the public procurements, the supervision, the settlement of disputes, liability and everything is actually put in one single public procurement act. It is different, as far as I remember, at least some 10 years ago, it was different in Germany where they had a lot of different acts for different things. In Latvia, I think the public communications or this is also set in a different act than the regular public procurement law that covers more things. Now, the existing law has been in place since 2007. Before that, there was another one, but in 2007, it was a new one was actually put in place. There have been several amendments to that. The last ones are since end of 2016. And what is important to say is that Estonians see themselves as an e-country, and we are also the forerunners of e-procurements in all of Europe. And we introduced the system in 2011, based on the public procurement register. So basically, what we are able to do right now is we can produce tender documentation. We can receive all the bids, we can evaluate all the bids, even contract people, companies with using this one register. The new law is based on the new European directives which are in place since 2014. The new law has not been enforced yet. We are, a bit, lagging back. And this is not due to the fact or due to the opinion of some of our closest neighbors that, as opposed to a regular person who consists of 60% of fluids, an Estonian consists of 60% of brake fluid. No, it's not because of that. It's actually because the approach that the Estonian state has taken is to basically build up a new law as opposed to the possibility of just amending the parts which relate to international tenders. And this has taken a lot of time. The new law was, well, they started with writing it in 2014 when the directives were in place. 2016 was the beginning of 2016 was the time when the government decided to pass it on to the parliament. And now it has been in the parliament for 1 year almost. So September will be the time when the new law will be in place. The statistics part. In 2016, more than 10,000 procurements were announced using the register. Basically, all of the tenders actually are going to the register, irrespective of from the cost starting at 10,000 euros. 12,000 contracts were signed, and the total amount of the contracts was at 3 billion euros. Taking into account that the Estonian state budget is 9 billion euros yearly, this shows that more than 30% actually of it is used for public, purchases works. Most of the procurements, we are lagging behind also in the issue that most of the procurements that we are doing are actually based on the lowest price tenders. In 2016, the amount was 84%, and this is actually opposed to Nordic countries like Norway, where the lowest price tenders are amount at 19% of the whole capacity of tenders. In Sweden and Finland, it's a basically 50-50 situation. In Belgium, it's 30% lowest price tenders. The thing is that we want, and it is makes more sense to do the tenders based on evaluating them on the economically most advantageous principles. But it has been avoided due to high subjectivity of the criteria set up. And everybody is, of course, afraid of the number of disputes that may come because of the subjectivity. So although the number of disputes with 10,000 procurements announced, we have had something like 260 disputes in Estonia yearly. Some 60 of them are actually decided in favor of the disputers. What might be interesting as well is that the cost of public procurement in 2011, when everything was basically submitted on paper, it was for the buyer and the bidders altogether, it was around 7,500 euros per procurement. Now, with the e-procurements more enforced, the cost has fallen to 2,300 euros. Bureaucracy costs money, so what can you say? So, hence, the new law actually wants to give way to less bureaucracy. This means that one of the possibilities that will be used in the future will be, for example, the qualification and conformity checks made before evaluation of the actual bids. These can be now postponed after to the time after the bid has been evaluated. The e-procurements, where we are so fine, actually, with 90%, there's the obligation of having 100% paperless procurements since autumn 2018. And what we are also quite happy about is that now the changes in the signed contracts will be way easier than according to the current law. Especially, it means when we talk about small-scale changes that the buyer or the seller couldn't foresee in the when they set up the tender or when the bids were actually submitted. Quality versus price. I also already said a couple of words about that. What is also important is better access to the public procurements. This means that when now we are talking for these 10,000 tenders yearly, we have an average of 3.5 bidders. I don't know who is the the 0.5 bidder, but it seems that these also exist. But now the better access means that small, especially smaller and mid-sized bidders will be will have a better opportunities to go and submit their bids. Better access also means that now it is foreseen that whenever possible we need to give way for splitting the tenders up in lots, and we need to explain when it is not done and why it's not done. So this again gives better way for the smaller bidders. The restrictions for misbehaviors, now there's better possibilities to kick out the foul players in the game basically bidders with a proven track record of not producing results or other problems. But at the same time, there will be introduced an instrument for remedy of disqualification grounds. So basically, the bidders can submit documents to prove that they are now okay. The qualification criteria, Kaspars again, there's not much to add to that. It's important to say that the criteria will be set up according to the, really the essential parts that are needed for the procurements. It means the most important things are experience of the company, experience of the specialists. A colleague of mine in maybe 10 years ago when I started with public procurements myself, he made a joke that he always qualifies the bidders where the expert has a proven track record of folk dancing written down in his CV. We will not ask these things to be shown or to be proven, so it's not probably that important in terms of some studies or so on. It's necessary to prove that the bidder or the winner of the procurement is capable of financing the activities, because of course we in the contracts we'll have to see how we will set up things. There might be some contracts with pre-financing, some without. So the company has to be capable of paying the wages for the workers. And it's important that the bidders will have and demonstrate a clear approach on how they will tackle the tasks that have that they need to deliver the results on. This is also common for all of the tenders, actually, or the procurements within the Rail Baltic framework, that the bigger tenders will be announced and all the documents will be in English. There might be some smaller scale things that are in Estonian, but it really depends on the relevance of the tender itself or the relevance of if local knowledge can be used or do we really need experts. Especially it goes about the studies. No? What I also must say that, of course, through this Estonian e-procurement register, all of the the higher amount tenders are also produced or shown in TED, which is the European procurement platform. But at the same time, we will not restrict us only to that, because again, if there is a smaller scale tender where we don't see that. Where we see that foreign companies could provide something really useful or something really new, we will certainly announce them also in English and show them also on TED. Of course, it's clear that local knowledge and local partners are needed for whichever activity that is done in Estonia, Latvia, or Lithuania, respectively. And it's also important to say that although the the procurement rules are basically similar in all of the three countries, still the nuances are the ones that actually play a role. So I encourage you to look for Estonian partners for the submitting the bids for consultations, it will certainly help help to produce a winning tender or a winning bid. Okay, time is over already, but I will just show you the. This is the current e-procurement register. It's also in English. I just produced the site where we can see the current tenders by Rail Baltic Estonia that are published. You have a usage manual in English language as well there. The questions and answers are unfortunately in Estonian language. These are the nuances that need to be probably talked about with your local partners. And in the closest future, the register will look like this, graphically better and functionally as well. Thank you for listening, and I hope you will have a lot of successes in bidding. Thanks.